Good morning, everyone. It's the 10th of November, 2023. And we're ready for the second chapter of Acts. One of the most important verses in that chapter is the 23rd verse, him being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God. Ye have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain. It was predetermined that Christ should die. Another scripture tells us that he was slain from the foundation of the world. It's hard for us to wrap our arms around that whole concept. The whole purpose of creation is redemption of God's people. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. There appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it set upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men out of every nation under heaven. Now when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded, because every man heard them speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, Behold, are not all these which speak Galileans? And how we hear we every man in our own tongue, wherein we were born. Parthians and Medes and Elamites and the dwellers in Mesopotamia and in Judea and in Cappadocia and Pontus and Asia, Phygia, Pamphylia and Egypt and in the parts of Libya about Cyrene and strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabians, we do hear them speak in our tongues the wonderful works of God. And they were all amazed and were in doubt, saying one to another, What meaneth this? Others mocking said, These men are full of new wine. But Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice and said to them, Ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words. For these are not drunken, as ye suppose, seeing it is but the third hour of the day. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaids I will pour out in those days of my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above, signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor and smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, the moon into blood, before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. You men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know. Him being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God, ye have taken him by wicked hands, have crucified and slain, whom God hath raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be holden of it. For David speaketh concerning him, I foresaw the Lord always before my face, for he is on my right hand, that I should not be moved. Therefore did my heart rejoice, and my tongue was glad. For moreover, also my flesh shall rest in hope, because thou wilt not leave my soul in hell, neither wilt thou suffer thine Holy One to see corruption. Thou hast made known to me the ways of life. Thou shalt make full of joy with thy countenance. Men and brethren, let me freely speak of you, the patriarch David, that he is both dead and buried, and his sepulcher is with us unto this day. Therefore, being a prophet, and knowing that God has sworn with an oath to him, that of the fruit of his loin, according to his flesh, he would raise up Christ to sit on his throne. He, seeing this before, spake of the resurrection of Christ, that the soul was not left that his soul was not left in hell, neither his flesh did see corruption. This Jesus that God raised up, whereof we are all our witnesses. Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted, and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, he has shed forth this which ye now see and hear. For David is not ascended to heaven, but he saith in himself, The Lord said unto my Lord, Sit thou at my right hand until I make thy foes thy footstool. Therefore let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God hath made that same Jesus, whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart, and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, Men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remissions of sin, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promises unto you and to your children and to all that are far off, even as many the Lord our God shall call. And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, Save yourself from this untoward generation. Then they that gladly received his word were baptized, and the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls. And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, and in breaking of bread and in prayers, and fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles, and all that believed were together and had all things in common, and sold their possessions and goods, and parted them to all men as every man had need. And they continued daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. Well, this chapter points to the inevitability of Christ calling his people. Notice in that last verse it says that he added to the church daily such as should be saved. It didn't say that he added to the church all. He wasn't preaching universal atonement there. He said he added to the church daily such as should be saved. Also, we see that in this second chapter, David is shown to have been revealed Christ in the Old Testament. He said, that David spoke of the resurrection of Christ when he said his soul was not left in hell, neither did his flesh see corruption. And you know, so David, he said, speaking to David, he said, David said, I foresaw the Lord always before my face, for he is on my right hand, that I should not be moved. David said that he saw Christ. Christ was revealed to him. And so, also we see that, like I stated earlier, it was predetermined that Christ would come and die for his people. He was delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God. This didn't take God by surprise when they crucified his son, because he's the one that determined by his counsel that he would come and die for his people. For him, by the being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God, ye have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain. It was predetermined beforehand that Christ would die. Just like it was predetermined that he would predestinate certain people unto adoption. And it says that he predestinated all of those that were called by God according to the counsel of his will, not according to the free will of man, because it's not of him that willeth nor of him that runneth, but God that showeth mercy. So anyway, this chapter is shows also that the Old Testament saints came to a saving knowledge of Christ just like the New Testament saints, through the power of the Holy Spirit revealing Christ to them. That's how all men come to Christ, is through the power of the Holy Spirit. In John 3, it tells us, the Spirit bloweth where it listeth, and no man knoweth the sound thereof, so is everyone that is born of the Spirit of God. May the good Lord be with you today, is my prayer. God bless.